Previously, in trucking season America, I got hit from the back and it damaged my trailer. If you only could go. Aye. I got called in the weigh station. No, bro. No. We are crossing the state line. We are gonna cross the state line, I believe. That is why we needed, they called us over here. And I forced myself in the lane. Come on, bro. Bruh! I'm slowing down in the mid. And come on! Thank you. Hello everyone, welcome to channel 941 and the 9th episode of Trucking Season America. We are in this cab. It's an international, as you can see. But what is it? Yes, let's go outside and find it out, shall we? So this is an international LT high-rise sleeper cab, 6x4 axles, 475 horsepower of engine with 1700 pound-feet of torque, and it has 240 gallons of fuel tank. This one is 18 Ultra Shift FO-22E318B-VXP. That means 18-speed gearbox with no retarder. Today we are hauling aircraft engine. Yes, in the last episode we talked about trying to haul aircraft engine, and we are hauling aircraft engine today, and it's only 11,904 pounds, and we are going to get $8,117 for that. This is a short journey, if we say so, because we are going to drive like 7 hours only. But I took this because, first of all, we are getting a truck that we did not drive yet in the cities, and the second is that we are going to east with it, and the third that we are getting this aircraft engine. So we are going today in Roanoke in Virginia. Yes, we are going in the east, in Virginia, from Nashville in Tennessee. So let's go inside and get going. Okay, what do we have here? Miles, that is good. We are ready to go. Let's Go. Do we go out from here? I certainly hope so. The only thing I am not liking about this truck setting is that it does not have any sat nav, inbuilt sat nav. Are we clear from the railway? We are not, but they are stopping nonetheless, so let's go. Nice truck. 45 is the limit, so let's put it to 45. Come on. Come on, bro. You are killing me, bro. And I am boxed over here. I can't go front. And I am having a feeling that I'll have to stop. Yeah, thought so. Thank you, but no thank you. Ha. Yeah, man. I barely managed to escape the, and this guy now. Oh, come on. So today we are going to discover something in Nashville. Most probably a recruitment agency, most probably a truck dealer, who knows? But the engine brake is very silent over here. Very silent, I have to say. I kinda like it, kinda not like it. I am very used to the kind of engine brake. And I don't know how am I feeling. Come on! He just had to stop. Anyway, not a problem. We have plenty of time in hand. So, yeah, we have 24 hours left for our job, and it's only gonna take 6.5 hours. We're Gucci, baby. We are good. Oh, what a start, man, what a start. It's see how it sounds. Okay, we have discovered a recruitment agency. So that was the discovery in Nashville. Let's go out of this city and let's, oh, it's 25. It is 25 miles per hour and now it's 65. Yeah, clear. And we will have to that's a good place to stop. I just missed it. No worries, we have plenty of time. We have fuel, we are not in any kind of trouble until and unless we face a detour. Only then we are in trouble. But that too shouldn't, like, it's 7 hours versus 11 hours in our driving, so we have 4 hours in our hand. So what's the problem? I don't see any problem. Oh, we're clear. We are clear. And we are in the freeway. So let's put it to cruise control and let's cruise. Or should I say, let's fly. I had another job that would give us much more money, but it would be going in Oklahoma. I did not want to go to Oklahoma. Come on. I did not notice. And we'll have to move into this lane. Bro. Oh, these mirrors have indicators. Huh? Where did the truck go? The truck was right in front of us. Did anyone see the truck? Anyway. No worries, this happens when a map has mismatch in the sections. Doesn't matter, we are in I-40 and heading eastbound I-40. It should be right, not heading eastbound, heading east, that means eastbound. I'm learning those things, man. Come on. even in Europe they don't use eastbound, westbound, these kind of things. Because unlike USA, Europe has many countries. Instead of states, there are countries. So it is like that. And we are exiting over here in Cooksville or Cookville. Let me go. We are through. We are waiting. Now I believe it's our turn. There is a truck dealer discovery over here, and as Kenworth has jobs, you can take job from Kenworth, so they are showing it as Kenworth. It is a Kenworth truck dealer, so that is how I know it's a Kenworth truck dealer. How did it become 50 suddenly? I love this. The indicators in the mirror. The turn signal in the mirror. They don't call it indicator. Cookville! Hello, Cookville! We have discovered Cookville. And we will have to go right. We'll have to take a right turn. No vehicle, no cars are going to the right, so we'll have to face the signal anyway. And that pickup is this SUV is, they are going to the right, and this is a very tight turn for a truck. It will go on the curb. I can't do anything about it. And we are on. And where is that? Where is the Kenworth? There it is, the Kenworth truck dealer. And we are driving very high. Kenworth truck dealer discovered. We were driving 45 in 35. This is why I like the we can't go through. This is why I like the sat nav in my dashboard, because I'm so used to looking at the dashboard instead of that map. We can go right. No, we can't. I thought this was the right turn. Now I can go. Okay, so far so good. We have discovered everything that we are supposed to discover. Come on, we won't get it, we won't get it, we won't get it. Okay, no worries. No worries there. That's a Mac. We haven't driven a Mac yet. I got the Mac, but it was going to Oklahoma. And I said, no, no way. And it was like, it was gonna take us 12 hours to reach there. But the weight was too much than the truck could take. It was like 300 something horsepower engine. So I said, no man, let's not take that. Let's take something powerful, because if the Mac was like 12 hours, if the Mac would take 12 hours, it was showing 12 hours, it definitely take us more than 12 hours to reach there. So I said, no, let's not take it. 340 horsepower, I believe. 345. And the cargo was like 46,000 pounds. So it is a very heavy cargo. Are we clear? Yes, we are. We are clear, baby. We are still in I-40. Come on. Still in I-40 heading east. What happened there? We are supposed to move left anyway. For some reason, they want us to stay left. Yeah, this is why. We can either go towards New York. Oh, oh, oh. Why do you slow down like that, man? It's a 70. Somehow this is the faster lane. I don't know how, but it is. And he is as smart as me. And I can't. He had to brake, right? He had to. Just to make sure. Bro, are you kidding me? You're trying to annoy me? Don't move into my lane. Don't. What? This truck can go only 70? I am in Knoxville discovered. Hello, Knoxville. That's Knoxville. I am going 70 miles per hour and my rev is almost at 1500, 1400 almost. So if there's 80 miles per hour speed limit, then I don't think I'll be able to go in 80. It will squeeze all the juice out of the truck's engine. I don't want to. If that's not my truck, I can, but I really don't want to. Doing that will only hurt your engine and your gearbox. Come on, don't go fast now. Don't go fast now. You are going slow, so go slow. Yes, just like that. I'll be crossing you and getting in the lane. Nobody's there. We're clear. Why are they asking us to move to the left again? I have to move to the left. I thought this is a three lane, but no, this is two lanes only, and we are going left again. The right one goes down. Let's slow down. This is I-81 we are getting into. And he's slowing down. Yeah, thank you. It's getting light. We are getting light over here. The sun is rising. 6:12 a.m. in the morning, and within 3.5 hours we are going to reach our destination. So we are pretty good, I should say. Do we have anything else in the way? No, we don't, but we may discover a few cities here and there. Other than that, we are totally clear. The waves of rays are coming. Waves are rising. Doesn't matter. We are not vampires that waves of light will hurt us, are we? We are not. So yeah, let's overtake them. We are still in route 81, I-81, interstate. Yes, Roanoke is over here. Nice. By 9:33 we are going to reach there. Kingsport discovered. Hello, Kingsport. It's far, far there. How do we discover it? How did we discover it? We have discovered many things for far, far away, if you remember the previous episode. So don't you worry. We are going to discover things like this. I am not comfortable with the distance we have. I am not comfortable with this distance. If he breaks, I'll be Ding! And there are no vehicles in the road, so I can easily move into first lane. It will be easier for me to move into first lane than go behind him. We are inside Virginia, or are we getting inside Virginia? So I believe this railroad divides Virginia and Tennessee. Oh, that was a drop. That was a good drop. Did you see the truck? Woo. And I could feel it in my hand. The drop, I could feel it. There's the SUV over there. He wanted to pass, but he can do nothing right now. I can't do anything as well. And don't you think the bus went too fast as it was entering the... Considering the speed that it came through, it did not keep it up. That's what you get for doing that to me. Okay, back to the view I need. No, not yet. It's a straight road, fairly straight road. And did you see the truck? Yes, this is like they are coming out. Whoosh, whoosh. They should slow down a bit. I don't know, they should. Come on. Go on the right, go on the right. No, he won't. They are moving right, so I can over here. And that's a motorway, so that's a freeway, so they are merging. I can understand they are slowing down, but that wasn't usual. And we are going 70 over 65. Beautiful day, beautiful day. And now it's 70. Let's go to 70. We are 1 hour out and we have gained almost 10 minutes. Almost 10 minutes. It's basically straight road. Basically a straight road. Industries over there. We are going out of the lane. OMG. Like, you should be able to hear it as well. Not only in the game, but through my microphone, the steering rumbles. 2 Newton meters is a lot. And the way it shakes, I reduced it almost to 70%. Come on, come on, come on, bro, let me go. I reduced it to 70% because I think 2 Newton meters is a lot. So 70% gives you 1.4 Newton meters of torque. Pound feet, I don't know, you can calculate it to pound feet. So that's a lot. I don't want to break my arm. And nowadays all the vehicles have power steering, so why do I need to push? I'm not driving a classic one. If there's a classic one, you can put it to, if your favorite truck, if your own truck is a classic truck, then you can put it to, I can make it tighter, but I love to believe that my truck is a newer one and it has got power steering. So it's easier for me to drive with one finger, just like that. Yeah, it gets tighter when I'm slowing down. It's supposed to. And there's standing over there waiting for someone to make a mistake. Are we gonna go? Yeah, we are going right. Ronok, hello Ronok. We have discovered Ronok. So we are almost in our destination, and I could feel that vibration as well. And the thing I was saying, that I made it. SCS gave me this option, and I put it like, it will, come on, slow, and it will be the slower you get, the steering will be jammed, it will be harder to turn around. I kept it like that. They gave this option in 1.43, I believe. 43 or 42. And I really love this upgrade. Wow, what a nice tunnel. And we are 2 minutes out. Why, man? Why are you slowing down? That's a big roundabout with nothing inside. If I hit those things, will they fall down like they're supposed to? How? Where are we going? That's a hidden road, by the way. That's a hidden road. We are not going to drive over there today. Let's not drive over there. But let's do one thing. Let's bump into these things just to check whether they drop or not. No, they don't drop. They make your truck damage. It was a nice test. There's a hidden road, and yeah, nothing to be worried, just a teeny mini damage. We were slow, So where do we park? And no, it started to rain. Come on. Come on, we're just there. And I can't pull my window down because of the rain. But if I could pull the window down, it would be very helpful. Then it would have been easier for me to see. This is why I can't. Yeah, barely, but I think we made it. We can go forth a bit. And it's on a slope, that is why I can't see a thing. I can't see a damn thing. I believe we are Gucci, baby. We are Gucci. A bit on the left side, we can correct it in no time. Whether or not it's perfect, and I thought I put it to her. So whether or not it's perfect, it is perfect. Let's go outside and unhook the trailer. So we actually did a pretty good job in this rain. Yeah, we did. Pretty good one. They are not gonna let us go in the back. So, let's unhook the trailer and get our money. We drove 366 miles and got 827 XP, and we did not level up. No worries, we will level up pretty soon. But before we end today's episode, let's check something else. We have discovered international truck dealers, Freightliner truck dealers, Mack truck dealers, Peterbilt truck dealers, Volvo truck dealers, Kenworth truck dealers. So we have discovered 6 truck dealers out of all the 7. The one we did not discover yet is the one. Yes, you guessed it right. Western Star. We did not discover any Western Star, but hopefully we will soon discover Western Star dealer. So let's keep an eye on it. As always, you can subscribe, or you don't need to subscribe. You can press thumbs up, though it is going to be good to press thumbs up. You can press thumbs down, though I'll be a bit like okay if you let me know what's the reason you put the thumbs down, and you just add my series into your own account. That's it. That way you can watch it whenever and wherever you want. So we hope to go somewhere over here or maybe over here. We'll see what we have in the future. Till then, stay safe, take care, and bye-bye. MUFS, signing off.